Hi, I'm Ted.
And I'm Kelly. We're here to talk about the power ports.
The power port is where the power cells are scored to charge the shield generator. An Alliance's power port is located between player stations 1 and 2 in the opponent's Alliance station.
There are three ports on each face: the bottom port, the outer port, and the inner port. The inner port is located within the outer port. Unsuccessful inner port shots will still score by staying in the outer port, but shots that bounce out are not scored. Notice that the bottom port is slightly lower than the three upper openings of the loading bay.
Power cells count towards the overall score, as well as charging the shield generator. Each port has a different point value, but all scored power cells count equally towards a shield generator charge.
However, the generator stops accumulating charge once that stage reaches capacity. The lights around the top of the power port indicate how close alliances are to the capacity of the current stage. Lights start at the top of the port and fill down the sides.
Once the current stage is at full capacity, yellow lights will chase through the light string, indicating that alliances need to access the control panel to activate that stage.
When that stage of the shield generator is activated, the lights go off and the fill pattern starts again. Be sure to watch the Trench Run and Control Panel video with Chuck and Amanda for full details about activating a stage of the shield generator.
The power port features a vision target for robots to use. The vision target is made of retroreflective tape and frames the bottom of the outer port.
Once power cells are scored, they will be available for the opposing alliance in the corral.
Check out the loading bay video with Malcolm and Fiona to learn more about how and when the power cells need to be re-entered into the field. Good luck, teams,
and may the force be with us all.